प्लेटिनम। Remedy commonly known for its egoistic image. But is this the only possible presentation of it? In this video, we will explore some rare and untouched aspects of platinum. After watching this video, you will be able to use it to deal with diseases like violent manias, depression, schizophrenia, anxiety neurosis, epilepsy, migraine, impotency, infertility, PCOD, fibroid, dysmenorrhea, prolapsus, hemorrhoids, and many more. We are going to study platina from more than 10 authentic Materia Medicas. Along with this, we will get to know what happens to the prover during the proving of platina at initial stage, intermediate stage, and at advanced stage, and how to use this in our clinical practice. So let's start. The original Spanish name is platino, which means like silver. In natural state, it is always found in association with other metals like rhodium, osmium, iridium, and palladium. The information we have about platina is been first credited by Dr. Staff and Dr. Gross, who were the pupils of Dr. Hahnemann, and is being described in second part of chronic diseases. Let's study the most susceptible part of platina, the mind. Like ignitia, platina deranges the coordination of mental functions and produces varieties of mental perversions. Hence, many features of platina produced during provings are similar to various well-known psychological disorders. And the state of patient who requires platina is many times the borderline between sanity and insanity. Platina can play a curative role at all three states: sanity, borderline, insanity, if correctly prescribed according to law of Semmelier. They are very sensitive emotional persons, basically ego-sensitive, who have susceptibility to get easily offended, easily vexed, and get angry with very unfriendly humor, under the influence of which they remain for a long time. When the pride is too large, it becomes more vulnerable. Platina's pride leads to great susceptibility to feel rejected, ignored, abandoned, forsaken, neglected, like natrum, ignitia, and magnesium mule. Similar to natrum, platina is averse to conversation and is aggravated with consolation. The easy to get hurt mental state results in fluctuations in emotional spheres. Like one day she is sad and morose, another day euphoric, one day calm, other day irritable. Remember, the alternation is also seen between mental and physical complaints as a keynote in platina. For example, headache with anxiety, sexual excitement with depressed mood. To such mental states, after effects of shock and grief, love disappointments, insults, leads to gradual deterioration of mental health, what we can call as mental traumatism. Platina deals wonderfully such mental traumas, similar to other remedies like Staphysacria, Colocynth, Natrum-Mure, Ignitia, and Phosphoric Acid. In that condition, platina appears similar to sepia or aurum, with profound weariness of life. Platina also exhibits hypersexuality. They develop premature and excessive sexual instincts, and they are very passionate about this, in which they found the pleasure to heal their wounded pride. Remember, sepia is close to platina in uterine affections with nymphomania. With time, these mental perversions get more intense and frequent, and her reactions becomes exaggerated for minor reasons. Their fight or flight response is easily triggered, causing rational part of the brain to turn off and the survival instinct to turn on. This makes platina act in ways that are inappropriate or out of proportion to the situation. This is the indication that the person is going to lose his sanity day by day. previously emotional, oversensitive Platina now becomes fearful of intensity of her own feelings, fearful of losing her sanity. She knows that she can be easily stimulated. Thus, she behaves in paranoid manner. Any serious thought creates trembling, oppressed breathing, violent palpitation in her whole body. Mood fluctuations starts punishing her. She feels torn between her emotion for her loved ones and her intense anger towards them. Her love is as passionate as her anger. Minor causes with intolerance of wounded pride excites impulses to kill or hurt someone. Any kind of emotional upset can click on the button now, and she may become insane. The characteristic of Platina that stands out even in this stage is her demonstrative behavior. Everything comes to notice of others. Unlike Ignatia, where the sufferings and perversions are deep buried in her mind. First, Platina becomes demonstrably apprehensive, then demonstrably lachrymous, weeping, with alternating moods of joy and laughter, and at last, demonstrably haughty and egoistic, where she could contempt or disrespect even the most venerable and respectful persons or object. Disordered sense of perception perverts her senses. She develops visual delusions of being too large and of smallness of others. The excessive sexual desires now turn into nymphomania or satyriasis, which means constant dwelling of sexual thoughts and desire to have sex very often, especially with different people. Now homosexuality, lesbian behavior are beyond her ability to control. The delusion of greatness and grandeur get mixed with it. To avoid self-contempt for that much sexuality, their mind start thinking that all of this is because of some external negative force, and she must align herself with something positive, like strong leader, successful person, religious group, or God himself. We can see many symptoms related to that in rubric form. Here is the summary chart of Platina's mind, which explains how she travels from oversensitivity to egotism, then mood fluctuations, which leads to bipolar behavior, which is the borderline between sanity and insanity, and finally, full-fledged insanity. Platina is a great remedy for all sorts of gynecological complaints. Itching, tickling, along with excessive sensitivity of genitals with intense sexual desires is a very characteristic of Platina. There is severe dysmenorrhea with violent cramps followed by numbness sensation, so intense that she shrieks in pain at every menstrual cycle. The menses of Platina appears too early and are too profuse, which reappears one after another. The menstrual blood is dark, clotted and sticky with unnatural sensitivity of genitals, so much that she can't even wear sanitary napkin easily. Platina cures metrorrhagia and menorrhagia of any origin, whether from regular menses or from uterine fibroid or prolapses. There are some other remedies which are very frequently indicated in all those conditions, like sickle cor, China, millifolium, chamomilla and sabina. But their blood is thin and of light color and with lesser pain during menses. While pulsatilla and sepia have severe pains but with scanty menses. While Platina have painful dark clotted menses with excessive sensitivity. In males, Platina cures habits of masturbation and erection during sleep with amorous dreams. Thus, Platina is a beneficial remedy to treat excessive sexual desires of both males and females and its effects on their mind and body. Their nerves remain excited most of the time. either from ups and downs of emotional activity or from excessive sexual indulgence, leading to prostrated and paralytic weakness. This is expressed as lethargy, numbness, stiffness, and coldness of various parts. The acts of masturbation or any emotional excitement may cause epileptic convulsions, headaches, attacks of migraine pains with characteristic sensation, that is numbness. This numbness along with pain is similar to chamomilla. The pains of platina increases and decreases gradually in characteristic manner, just opposite to belladonna. Platina is suited to hysterical persons with depressed mind and debilitated body. It is one of the prominent remedy for globus hystericus, like that of asafoetida, ignitia, and sepia. Platina is the best known antidote for lead poisoning because it produces very similar signs and symptoms during its proving, like constriction and tight bondage feeling in abdomen with violent cramps, flatulence, fermentation of food in stomach, constipation with paresis of intestine, and inability to strain during stool. And one important symptom, hard and half digested stool which adheres to the anus like clay. So, platina should not be limited as a haughty and egoistic medicine. Try and understand every aspect of it to utilize its full potential. This was the only goal of this video. I am Dr. Shubhendu Verma, and this channel is an effort to simplify homeopathic subjects so that it becomes easily comprehensible for everyone. Let us know in the comment section which topic you want to be covered next, either a medicine, case taking, repertory section, philosophies of organism, concepts of organism, or any disease. For more such video, stay in touch by liking and subscribing the channel and click on the bell icon so that you get the notification of our next video. Thank you.